ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಧುಮೇಹ ರಕ್ಷಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಖ್ಯಾತನಾಮವಾಗಿರುವಂತಹ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಮೋಹನ್ಸ್ ಡಯಾಬಿಟಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಾಲಿಟಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಮಂಗಳೂರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಆರಂಭಗೊಂಡಿದೆ. ಮಂಗಳೂರಿನ ಲೈಟ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಹಿಲ್ ರಸ್ತೆಯ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಸ್ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಆರಂಭವಾಗಿದೆ. ಮಂಗಳೂರು ಮತ್ತು ಸುತ್ತಮುತ್ತಲಿನ ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳ ಮಧುಮೇಹಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಸೂಕ್ತ ಚಿಕಿತ್ಸಾ ಸೌಲಭ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ನೀಡಲಾಗುವುದು. ಮಧುಮೇಹಕ್ಕೆ ಸಮಗ್ರವಾದಂತಹ ಚಿಕಿತ್ಸೆ ನೀಡುವಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಂಚೂಣಿಯಲ್ಲಿರುವ ದೇಶದ ಪ್ರಮುಖ ಆಸ್ಪತ್ರೆ ಇದಾಗಿದೆ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಸುರೇಶ್ ಟಿಎಂ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ದೀಪ ಬೆಳಗಿಸುವ ಮೂಲಕ ಉದ್ಘಾಟಿಸಿದರು. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರೊನಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫರ್ನಾಂಡಿಸ್, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರಭಾ ಅಧಿಕಾರಿ, ಸಿಡ್ನಿ ಡಿಸೋಜಾ, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಿ ಮೋಹನ್ ಮತ್ತಿತರರು ಉಪಸ್ಥಿತರಿದ್ದರು.
Recognize that there is a saying in the Vedas, almost 80 million people with pre-diabetes and many other ethnic groups in the world. These are not new statements. Each one is in China. But we will not, unfortunately, we will get the gold. What we get is for standing absolutely still, shooting or being 60, 70 years. That is why they are having more diabetes. How is it?
Well, I thought it was very thoughtful because one was Dr. Mohan. Like I just told Dr. Sidney sometime back that you may know him and it's not necessary he should know you. That is the type of aura he has got in India and world over. I know in 1990s my mom, I took her to MD Diabetic Specialty Center in Roypuram in Chennai, and I was amazed. There were people who had come there from abroad. And for the first time I saw a huge machine which was processing the samples of blood and urine and giving results, and you have to do your GTT. And within 3 hours you knew, the doctor would see you and he would also prescribe to you what has to happen, and then you go and meet them and start the process. So they were familiar to me, Dr. Ramachandran. I've been there once, but I memorized their names because they were such stalwarts. Dr. Rima, Dr. Mohan, Dr. Vishwanathan, his father, huge photos used to be hung in that MD Diabetic Specialty Center of his father. Subsequently, once in a year when this day for conduct of a diabetic day comes, their articles will be there in the media, in the newspaper, about the preventive steps, what's happening in the market, the statistics and research, as well as what is likely to come up in the future. Everything will be given in that center page or an additional page which used to come. Since I am a Chennaiite, I used to get to see it. It's happy that this is the 26th branch, because the number 26 is this figure of 8, numerology. I'm always bashed with it. And again, when 26 came around, I said, okay, I think I was time to be here. Numerology connects me here. Diabetes per se is a lifestyle disease. I got a doctor just sitting behind me, a lieutenant commander. What is diabetes? When I asked him, he said it's a lifestyle disease. And military guys have a bad lifestyle but a good military bearing. So we balance the lifestyle with our big bearings. And we do it with...
Wrong in it. He was making a statement and he said, I am the greatest. A lot of arrogance into that. But still, he was making a statement saying that he will be the best. He is going to be the greatest. Okay, so the Vedas say there's nothing wrong in doing that. But the Vedas puts a small rider in that, you know. And that rider is, it says, oh Lord, but at the end of the day, when my life is done, I must be beaten. Even if I am the greatest, I must be beaten. And I must be beaten by two people. One is my own child. If my child doesn't beat me, then I have failed as a parent. That's a great failure. You know, there are many, many great leaders I don't want to name, including some at our national level, some of our greatest of the people who have this country who have failed as parents. They've served the nation, they've done so much, but their own family, they have not been able to do that. So that's a great failure. So where it says that parent has been defeated. And if my child defeats me, then I'm the greatest. And of course, I have done that beauty also. But it doesn't stop there also. It says, I must also be beaten by my students. Because ultimately, if a student doesn't beat me, then I have not been a good teacher. I have been a very selfish teacher, proclaiming myself to be the best. Apart from that, if I am able to raise a cadre of students whom I am able to bring to my level or greater than me, two things happen. One is, they say, but that man was his teacher, you know. So then you go up in the stature even more. And second, your legacy will live on forever. You always don't have a legacy. With you, everything dies. There's no legacy. Okay. So when my father started the field of diabetes in 1948, I wonder why he started in 1948. He was virtually not diabetes then. So I don't know how many diabetes in whole India, I probably could count them. And yet he thought in 1948 that a specialty called diabetes was necessary. By the time I joined him in 1971, as an 18-year-old, the first year student, I joined him and seriously started working with him from first year. By the time the specialty had already been developed. So for me, it was very easy to stand on his shoulders. But he felt that as a specialty, you have to train different people. And I took it, I started saying that we train more and more students. And today, if you say we have 26 branches,